Hello, let's make a painting. Excuse me. All right. Paper on the glass, and let's see what we're going to do today. Now, it's rainy outside, so if you hear a thunderstorm, it's rainy. So that's what we're doing today. There's no reason to try to discover or search for anything. And usually I search a lot about painting, but today is all over the place. So that's what we're doing. Blue for the top portion of the paper and just tapping, no mixing, no nothing. Just tap. A lot of clouds, very heavy clouds just before the storm. Maybe it start raining a little bit, sprinkle a little bit, but that's about it. It's not, the storm not there yet. Heavy wind. And we're gonna let the water do her stuff. That's it. That's the sky, by the way. It should be enough. It's look very interesting to me. A lot of wind, a lot of movement going on. I'm just gonna let it blend and do what it need to do. For the ground, some red, I think is a nice contrast between the blue, dark blue and dark red. And we're gonna unite them with some green, which one is kind of dirty green. I didn't clear my brush here, so I'm just gonna keep going. I think that's a gold green that I'm using. And I'm just call everything green. All the blues are blue, all the greens are green. I know their names, it's just, I like to simplify things. Life is already too complicated. So it's just blue, green, yellow, stuff like that. Five colors in total. All right, let's go with the horizon line. I like the white parts in the sky, but I feel like the it's too much white on the horizon line. So I'm gonna take some of the yellow and I'm gonna do maybe, you know how when there's a storm and the clouds are very heavy and they already, oh, by the way, look at the clouds, how they forming that like a wind in the middle. It's like a vortex in the sky. It's just gorgeous stuff. The water creates so many amazing things. I don't even have to do anything. Just let the water do the stuff. But anyway, you know how the light is going through the clouds, and when the clouds are very heavy and they're up the sky and they're very dark and there is like the light, the sun is going through the bottom of it. It's like a big patches of clouds and the light is under it. Anyway, take the palette knife and grow up some bush. No, like a tall grass. I just want something to emphasize a little bit more and complement the wind that is going on in the sky. So we're gonna make some tall grass, well, kind of medium grass, moving from left to right, just to show up the wind a little bit better. Scratch it up some of the paper. Now everything is kind of start blending. So we have this details on the foreground, which one is the grass. That's fine. The sky, again, we're not going to touch it. I really like this kind of vortex wind representation that is happening in the middle. It's kind of going from left and right. It's like just moving around. Anyway, I just want to separate them a little bit better. And I will take a black wash, not a black paint, but black wash. And I'm going to put it right next to the yellow. So we can boost the yellow. We can have this high contrast. And we can clearly see now the horizon line. And I'm here anyway with the black grass, so am I gonna clean my brush and some throwing shadows from the grass. And of course they stay like a spot right now, so palette knife again. Just a little bit, not too much. I don't wanna destroy it, I just create it. Now, of course, for the sky, we're going to keep the wind, But I feel like we gotta show up some form. I mean, some formations, some clouds, and I'm gonna do some puffy clouds with the brush. Just simply remove the paint. And the other thing is, I'm not gonna clear my brush. I will not clean my brush. The reason for that is I want it clean. I want a fluffy clouds, but I also want them to be kind of blending with the rest of the color. So I kind of need it bluish, just lighter version. But I still want them to be puffy. So that's what we're going to do. You can hear the thunders outside. Little bit more. And I'll try to make some kind of movement from left to right, of course, to complement the grass on the foreground and the midground, and the wind on the top of the painting. Just tap, 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 tap. I don't want to overdo it. I think this is fine at this point. Maybe a little bit up there. I really don't want to destroy that thing over there. Maybe some light on the foreground. Just to break down the monotonous of this colorful foreground and the midground. This should be enough. There. And there we go. Watercolor, abstract, landscape.